The River Cottage baby celebration is looming, and Steve's roped in his foraging buddy John Wright to help him brew up something boozy for the party.
How are you doing?
I see they're giving you a job that suits you at last.
Yeah, I know, it's a bit of a promotion. You know how often you and I go out and the woods might be a place where we go foraging? Well, the place where we're going foraging today is made of wood.
What, it's up a tree?
It's a cupboard.
It's a cupboard, yes.
This is stealing, isn't it? You want me to steal stuff.
It's not stealing if you don't get caught.
Oh, well, that's okay.
Steve's decided to make lashings of ginger beer, albeit a proper grown-up version.
Ginger, little bit of honey, sugar, lemons, brewer's yeast, water.
It's about the simplest homebrew there is, but one of the best.
So it's a lot easier than foraging in the wild.
See, I knew you'd come round to my way of thinking.
You'll need to rustle up a few recycled bottles to hold the brew.
And put off. Sterilising fluid in.
Rinsing the bottles with sterilising solution will stop unwanted bacteria from spoiling the brew.
So, brewer's yeast.
A Bordeaux white, that should be lovely, shouldn't
lovely.
It?
Lovely, great. Quarter teaspoon in the bottom, in each one.
Each bottle is an individual batch and gets one cup of sugar.
How do you know that's a cup? And then, like, why can't you measure it properly?
Don't worry about the numbers, John. Let yourself go.
The juice of one lemon per bottle gives the drink the right tang. And plenty of fresh root gingers going in.
All of that ginger in there. Now, a little bit of honey.
Clear honey is optional, but it'll give a little extra richness to the drink. Divide the ginger, lemon and honey mixture equally between the bottles. And half fill each with cold water. Shake well to dissolve all the sugar and thoroughly mix the ingredients, and then top up with more water.
Oh, lovely action.
It's all in the wrist.
And leave a little bit of space at the top to allow for expansion.
Lovely. Plus one. Tidy. So,
when's this going to be ready?
Well, not for another 48 hours. So we'll put that somewhere safe. Come back to it in a couple of days' time.
2 days later, and it's time to find out whether their ginger brew will fall flat or be a sparkling success.
Steady. Don't drop them, it could be a terrible accident.
They're lovely and clear.
Thank you very much, Stephen.
How's that?
Sorry. Oh, God.
Right, well.
Well, that worked, didn't
that's it? That's
good. Actually, it's very encouraging. With that much gas, there must be quite a bit of alcohol in there.
The beer should really be strained before serving, but these eager brewers can't wait to sample their own work.
Cheers, old boy.
Gingery.
Isn't it?
It's fizzy.
Yeah, I like it.
It's got the fizz, it's got the taste, but has it got any kick?
I'm going to measure the alcohol content.
Oh, you're such a geek. What's this? I'm interested.
It's a hydrometer.
A what? Hydrometer?
It's a hydrometer. It will measure the alcoholic content. Oh, you need a, can you top me up?
I've lost it.
Wait a second. Wait.
I've lost it. That's no good.
No, wait. Keep it still. I can still read it. One side.
This is 2% alcohol, so that's 4% proof. Well, that's the same as a lager, same as a beer.
Well, there you go, ginger beer.
Ginger beer.
Yeah, brilliant. Oh, what a result. I'm really chuffed.
And it tastes good too.
Brilliant.
Cheers.